right, boys and girls, well, now that we understand place value of our decimals and where they live after the decimal, we're going to now talk about comparing and ordering our decimals. So again, when we talk about comparing and ordering, I want you to think about our money situation and think of all of our decimals being money. So when we compare decimals, we're always going to be looking for the most amount of money before and after the decimal. So what's important to remember is that change matters, cents matter when we're comparing decimals. So if we both have the same amount of dollars, one might have more because it has more change in his pocket than the other. So you have to look at the entire number, not just the whole numbers. So please remember also, when you are comparing numbers, that the alligator mouth eats the bigger number, okay? My alligator mouth eats my 5, not my 2. Because 5 is more than 2. So let's look at some numbers and see how we do it comparing them. Here's my first numbers that I want you to look at and compare. Again, thinking of them as money, $6.75, or 6 75 hundredths, compared to 3 24 hundredths, or $3.24. Now, just as we did in first and second grade when we were comparing whole numbers, we start with the digit in the largest place value and compare those first. So in this case, I'm going to be looking at my 3 and my 6. And I'm going to say, which number is bigger? Well, they're both in the ones place, so that doesn't help me. But I can look at them and say, which is more, $6 or $3? I know $6 is more, so the rest of it doesn't even matter. Automatically, because I have more dollar bills on this side than I do on that side, my $6.75 I know is the winner. And the alligator takes that money and goes shopping. Now let's look at this one. 8 25 hundredths compared to 8 25 thousandths. Now you may recall from a previous section that I said you can add as many zeros to a number after a decimal, and it does not change the value of that decimal. So if you know that, that might help you. It might be a little sneak peek. But we're going to attack this the same way we did the first problem. I'm going to look at the number in my largest place value, and the ones place is larger than my tens, 4 hundredths. Well, that doesn't do a whole lot to help me now, does it? I have an 8 on my left, and I have an 8 on my right. So I have to move to my next place value. My next place value is a 2 and a 2. Still does not help me. They're still the same. I have to move to my next place value, a 5 and a 5. Same again. Drats. Let's go to the next place value. Well, this number doesn't have any more place values. And this place value is a 0. Now, what I know about decimals, as I said earlier, is I can add zeros to the ends of a number after a decimal, and it does not change the value of that decimal. So because of that, I can add a 0 there, and it does no difference. It is still $8.25. So if I add that 0 there, now they both have zeros there, and that's the end of the number. That being said, these two numbers are equal. Let's look at this number. 9 231 thousandths compared to 9 23 hundredths. Let's attack it the same way. ones place of both numbers, I have a 9. In my tens place, I have a 2 in both numbers, followed by a 3 with both of those numbers. And then this number has a 1 in its thousands place, and this number has nothing in its thousands place. Keeping that same idea from the previous problem, I know I can add a 0 there, and it does not change the place value. That being said, what is greater, 1 thousandth or 0 thousandths? Believe it or not, this number, 9 and 231 thousandths, is slightly larger than the other. So those are three examples on how to compare decimals. Think of them like money, and remember, zeros can be added to the end of a number after a decimal. We're going to move right into now ordering our numbers. And today we're going to order this first set from least to greatest. From least to greatest. And that means
to the biggest, most gigantic number listed.
Personally, my favorite way to do this is to make sure, for one, that all of my numbers have the same number of digits after the decimal. So I'm going to start there. I'm going to make sure all of my numbers have the same number of digits behind my decimal. So there are my four numbers that I have listed here on my notebook. I just wrote them right on top of each other to be able to see them more clearer. Honestly, I prefer this way to be able to order numbers. I can see them much better. Okay? So again, I'm looking for my itty bitty teeny tiniest number in the whole wide world. So the first thing I'll go to is a teeny tiny number. So I'm going to look at my ones place, because that's my largest place value digit in this set of numbers. They all are in the ones place. Now I notice with these four numbers that I have listed here that they are all a 5. All these numbers in my ones place are a 5. So that helps me not at all. I then go to my next place value, my tenths place, and I look for my itty bitty tiniest number. 0 is a really small number. It's much smaller than 4. Or 4. Oh, but look, I have another 0 here. So I'm going to focus my attention on these two numbers and see which one is the smallest of those two numbers. So I go to my next place value of those two numbers. 1 lives a 4, 1 lives a 6. Which one is the teeny tiniest number? My 4 is my teeny tiniest number. That tells me that this whole number is my smallest number listed here, which, if you can read through the Scribble Scrabble, is 5 and 4 hundredths, which is my first number. So all the lines provided are on below it. I'm going to write 5 and 4 hundredths. Now I'm going to do a couple more things. I'm going to cross it off of my list so I don't bother with it anymore. And then I'm going to circle it on here so I know I've used it. And then there were 3. So I look at these 3 numbers, and again, now out of these 3 numbers, I'm going to determine which one is the teeny tiniest number of all these numbers. So I go back and I say, well, they're still all 5s, that didn't change. Now I have a 4, a 4, and a 0. Which one is the teeny tiniest number? This 0 is the teeny tiniest number in the whole wide world. So that tells me that that is my next number, 5 and 64 thousandths. So we're going to identify which one is the teeny tiniest number. digits in my place, next place value in my hundredth place are zeros. Still does not help me. Then I go to my next place value, a zero and a six. Which one is the teeny tiniest number in the whole wide problem? The zero is the teeny tiniest number in the whole wide problem. So that tells me that this number is going to be my next.
That means the number left must be the largest, most magnificent, largest, greatest number on our list.
Because it's the only one left. And it's the only one up here. So there are my numbers ordered from least to greatest. Let's try one more right quick. For this one, let's go from
greatest
to least,
or
biggest to smallest. Please write those numbers down. And if I were you, I would write them also in list form as I had done for our last problem. That's what I'm going to do at this exact moment in time. So here's my list. Now I hope that when you made your list, you noticed that this number here, 2 and 46 hundredths, does not have the same number of digits that the other numbers have. So I'm going to fill it in with a zero, because I can. And it does. Hooray! We have now successfully ordered and compared decimals. Please bring any and all questions to class tomorrow. I look forward to seeing your bright and smiling, beautiful faces.